Good morning, children. Today we are going to do make sentences of the difficult words of your lesson, Henry. We've already read the lesson. It's a very small lesson and a very interesting lesson. And the first word which I would like to tell you about word meaning about make sentences would be slender. This is a word, slender. Now what do you mean by word slender? Slender means thin. Slender means thin. So what sentence will you make it with slender? Can you make some sentence with slender? Now I can just give you some clues. Slender can be a person's body, or it can be some leaves, or it can be somebody's finger. Now slender in the lesson is being referred to as the toes and fingers of the chameleon, which was slender. Okay, so you can make a sentence referring with a book, with a text, or you can make it a general sentence also, like these plants' leaves are long and slender. These plants' leaves are long and slender. Now when you see a plant, some of the plants have very long leaves and they are slender also. They are thin. They are thin leaves. Or you can also say like this, she has got a beautiful slender figure. Beautiful, she has got a beautiful sundar. Slender means patli figure. Or you can say, she is slender. She is thin. She is slender. But he is stout. Stout means mota. Slender means patla. Just the way when you were young, you used to say fat and thin. So there is another word for thin, which is slender, and another word for fat, which is stout. So I have given you three sentences. It's just an example. You can make different sentences also with the help of slender word. Like, I have already told you, the chameleon has long and slender fingers and toes. Or she has a beautiful figure, slender figure. And her fingers are long and slender. Her fingers are, anybody's her fingers are. Suppose you can talk about your parents, your mother also. Your mother must be having long and slender fingers. Slender means thin. Or my sister is very tall and slender in shape. She's tall and slender. She's very tall and she is thin. So I've given you a few examples of slender, which means thin. Now the second word is hurling. Now what do you mean by hurling? You've already done hurling. Hurling means, now what do you mean by hurling? Hurling means throwing something with a lot of strength. Throwing something. You may be throwing stones, or you may be throwing some anything on somebody with strength. That is in anger. Jab aap kisi ke upar gusse se kuch phekte ho, usko bolte hain hurling. So who was hurling in the lesson? All the family members were hurling stones at the chameleon. So what sentences will you make with this hurling? Now I can give you some example, like the gang. Gang kiska gang hota hai? Thieves ka gang. The gang of thieves, were hurling rocks at the police. The gang of thieves, जो चोरों का गिरोह था, चोरों का ग्रुप था, गैंग था, दे वर हर्लिंग स्टोन्स एट द पुलिस सो दैट दे कुड रन. ओके, और द क्राउड ऑफ पीपल वर हर्लिंग स्टोन्स और वर हर्लिंग स्टिक्स और वर हर्लिंग स्टोन्स एट द पुलिस स्टेशन. ओके, और द बोट रॉक्ड वाइल्डली. What is a boat? Boat is sailing in the water. The boat rocked wildly, hurling him into the water. द बोट वॉज रॉकिंग. नाउ व्हाट डू मीन बाय रॉकिंग? बोट वॉज टॉसिंग इन द वॉटर. बोट जो थी वो विंड में, वो पानी में टॉस कर रही थी, क्योंकि पानी में क्या आ गया था, पानी में भूचाल आ गया था. पानी में क्या आ जाता है, जब पानी में सुनामी आ जाता है तो बोट रॉक करती है ना, रॉक मतलब टॉस करती है. सो द बोट रॉक्ड वाइल्डली, हर्लिंग हिम इनटू द वाटर. हर्लिंग हिम मतलब ज़ोर से उस जो आदमी उसमें बैठा था उसको हर्ल कर दिया पानी में गिरा दिया. सो हर्लिंग मीन्स व्हेन यू थ्रो समथिंग विद स्ट्रेंथ. इट कैन बी अ मैन थ्रोन इन द वाटर, इट कैन बी यू आर थ्रोइंग विद योर हैंड एंड समथिंग इन द वाटर, समथिंग ऑन इट. सो हर्लिंग मीन्स थ्रोइंग स्टोन्स. एंड इन द लेसन यू कैन से the family was hurling stones at the chameleon in the garden because they were all threatened, they were all frightened, they were afraid that chameleon can do something. So after hurling, the third word is brandishing. Now what do you mean by brandishing? Brandishing matlab स्टिक को लेकर के शेक करना, ऐसे ऐसे करके. ब्रैंडिशिंग मीन्स टू शेक और वेव, टू वेव एट समबडी. ओके, सो एंड टू शेक और वेव इन अ थ्रेटनिंग मैनर, मतलब इसको डराने के लिए शेक करना अपने हाथ को या हाथ से स्टिक को शेक करना, कि जैसे आप किसी को डरा रहे हो, किसी को धमका रहे हो. गॉट इट? दैट इज ब्रैंडिशिंग. So what would be the sentence with brandishing? She brandished a stick at the dog. So when the dog doesn't listen to you, what do? You brandished with a stick. She brandished a stick at the dog. And another sentence, I could see that he was brandishing a knife. मैं देख सका कि वो जो था वो knife से brandishing कर रहा है. Knife ऐसे से करके मेरे को knife दिखा रहा है. क्यों दिखा रहा है? Maybe he wants to make somebody, he is threatening somebody, डरा रहा है किसी को. So I could see that he was brandishing a knife. Or my grandfather was brandishing a stick when I was misbehaving. When I was misbehaving at home, my grandfather brandishing a stick at me. He was brandishing a stick at me. After brandishing, you always use at. Now you can use brandishing in your own words, in your own sentence, because you have come to know what you mean. But brandishing means to wave at somebody in a threatening manner. Chahe aap haath se brandishing kariye, chahe aap stick se kariye, that is brandishing. Now the next is patient. Patient means careful. So patient is very simple. You can make a sentence with patient. Be patient and do your work. The class should remain patient in the class, in the school. And in the hospital, you should be patient. And please do your work patiently. So you can use patient in the sentence and can write. Now the last proverb is, proverb or a phrase which is called risen in arms. Now what do you mean by risen? What do you mean by this word? Risen in arms? Now, risen in arms, what is the meaning? Risen in arms? Risen in arms means we're angry and protesting about something. जब लोग बहुत गुस्से में होते हैं और protest, मतलब कुछ कुछ protest करते हैं, मतलब against हो जाते हैं किसी के खिलाफ कुछ चीज़ मतलब बोलते हैं, उसको बोलते हैं risen in arms. अब rise, rose, risen. Rise मतलब हाथ को उठाना, rise मतलब the sun rises in the east. Rise मतलब उठना, rose मतलब उठा, risen मतलब उठा था. तो तीन form of verb है, rise, rose, risen. On the book it is risen in arms, so you can use it in any form. Now I will tell you the sentence. At last the people rose up in arms and defeated the cruel rulers. Now in some kingdom there must be some cruel rulers, and all the people they rose in arms. Sab khade ho gaye apne haathon ko upar karke ki hum is ruler ki baat nahi manenge. So at last the people rose up in arms and defeated the cruel. They defeated the cruel rulers. Now the second sentence could be, now, risen in arms means when somebody speaks against somebody. So the workers of the factory workers, they have risen in arms when their salary was deducted. Jab factory ke workers ki salary deduct hui, they all rose in arms, or they have risen in arms. They have risen up, unhone haath khade karke khub uske against chillaye, protest kiya. That is called, they have risen in arms, or they rose in arms. You can use it in any way, any form. And another one is, residents are up in arms about plans for a new road along the beach. Now when the government started making road along the beach, the residents of that place, they rose in arms. That means they stood against this plan of the government not to make road along the beach. If they'll make a road along the beach, the beauty of the beach will be finished and their houses will have no beauty. So they all rose in arms, the residents of a place, they rose in arms when the government had plans to make a road along the beach. So rose in arms, risen in arms is always used against something which is not good or which is not right. So I hope all these sentences you will be able to write by yourself. Maybe you can write my sentence, or maybe you can find out some new sentence, or maybe you can make a sentence by yourself. So I hope you have understood slender, hurling, brandishing, patient and risen in arms. So I think make sentences would be over. Only 5 sentences I have given. And I hope you have understood the lesson. And tomorrow we will be doing the question answer of the lesson, or maybe the back exercises we will start, and we may end up doing question answers also and finish the lesson as soon as possible. So thank you.